Hannah Williams and the Affirmations, and we are just landing in Tokyo, in Japan, before we play for the very first time at the awesome, legendary Club Blue Note. And we are so excited. I'm just feeling really nervous and anxious about delivering 4 shows in 2 days, which I've never done before. And there's a lot of pressure because I really, really, really want to deliver an excellent show 4 times. But it's really scary and I don't know if I can. So I'm really doubting myself and I don't want to disappoint anybody.
Know that your mid-range is just as impressive.
That's it.
And that if you have something that happens with your voice at any point in these next 2 days, know that that is good and to use it. The raspiness, the lack of the upper register, all of it is good, you know. Like what comes out of problems is incredibly creative, and we're all there supporting you. Do you know what I mean? You know, then you will put on an excellent show. I've got absolutely no doubt about it, and that is the most important thing. So.
Just want to say, I love you guys.
On our way to Blue Note Tokyo in the Blue Note bus for our first show at Blue Note. It's a bit exciting and today is an absolutely beautiful day. The sun is shining, we've all had a lovely morning. This is going to be a pretty historical day for Hannah Williams and the Affirmations, really. Oh, I just can't wait. It's going to be awesome.
So tired now, but I can't close
soul music demands that you are 100% emotional and transparent.
Yeah, totally, yeah.
So it's like you can't hide.
Yeah.
You can't hide behind it.
Yeah, it's overly exposed.
Absolutely. It's a complete exposition of your soul.
Yes,
quite literally of your soul. And the for me the emotions have to be real.
Yes.
I can't fake it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I always feel like I have to really dig something up to be able to perform that way, which is it's exhausting because it means I'm just permanently emotional. But but it's great, and I it feels so liberating and so freeing to be able to see like that. So maybe that's the reason I'm drawn to that particular style of music. I don't know, but the vintage sound. I mean, that's got a lot to do with, you know, the musical direction that that James has. The way in which the album is recorded, and a whole host of other things that kind of play into that from everybody's different inputs and influences.
Yeah.
You know, everyone in the whole band is part of the creative team.
Do you argue sometimes?
Of course.
Yeah.
Of course, but from arguments comes the best possible result.
Of course.
From the top, A, G sharp, G, F sharp, D.
D
flat.
So the second one, get rid of it,
just do the same thing.
That's what we did. A, G sharp, G, F sharp.
I've heard that all of the boys think you're crazy. I treat you so bad. Why do you want me? I've heard that all of the girls, they started to hate me. Oh, to stay in your heart and treat.
Doing the sweeping up to the high
held
chords, that is basically the musical cue for everyone else to be going at the peak of our supporting
intensity.
But if we've got nowhere to go, it's going to just naturally drop back a bit and
just
loses the impact at the end of it. So, but
yeah, okay.
It's funny because I personally think that having solos up, down like that in intensity and just ending when they want to end actually sounds quite nice. I hear what you're saying about it should end at the peak of when it's like absolutely fucking skinny.
You should end it at a peak. Yeah, I mean, in every solo there's peaks of trust. Rather than ending like what Treasure's saying, like with a peak and then just a short period, that's just weird because we've also got a tag of these chords.
Especially because it goes to a tag at the end of the solo.
Can I speak as an audience member? It does feel a bit confused. Like, because I know what you're doing and I trust that you will eventually come back together, it has there has been a bit of kind of haphazardry towards the end, and like the playoff between the trombone and the sax has been there's actually been some kind of, although it's crazy, like there is actually some clarity in kind of the conversation that's happening there. But I do agree that the end of that key solo, it is just a little bit, it's just unclear. I don't think it's anything that dramatic. And I get what you're saying, but I think...
At the end of the key solo, it's unclear.
It's just unclear. And exactly like these guys have said, it's just unclear when you're finishing. So as long as you're in control of that and you make eyes at everyone, then there's no problem.
Let me see.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let me see.
Over the last few days, really. It's been a really weird, amazing, frightening, scary, brilliant, life-changing few days where I've kind of been really scared that I couldn't deliver the show that everybody wanted, but at the same time kind of finding that I have a completely different show in me that I never knew was there. And the band have just been playing so well and just, you know, holding me together. And yeah, I think I found a completely different way of performing that is possibly more powerful and more emotional than kind of what I came out to do. I just found this completely different and very natural way of singing with different parts of my voice that everybody's saying is ultimately better than what I was doing before. So yeah, it's a funny place to be in, but I'm actually really pleased that that's happened because it's given me this completely new set of skills that I didn't know I had. So, in a nutshell, I feel pretty damn cool.
So wonderful to see a full house. Thank you so much for coming. This is our last show here. This is the fourth of four, and I promise you it'll be the best.
Is a lie which I try not to describe.
Do you think it's
time is like a mountain that's impossible to climb.
Cheers, everyone!
Oh, cheers!
Tokyo, done!
To the best gig we ever did! Yeah.